really despise changing lenses when I'm traveling. I hate fumbling in my bag in crowded areas, and there's always the risk of getting dust on the sensor. I thought by getting the Sony 24 to 240 millimeter lens, it might be the solution to all of my problems. I thought that with the 24 millimeters, I'd be able to get pictures of buildings and things. And then if I saw a boat out on the lake, I might be able to zoom in enough with 240 millimeters. But besides this thing weighing over 700 grams, it has a really stiff zoom ring. And I just wanted to show you the kind of images that I was able to get, as well as some video clips. I noticed a few issues, and I just wanted to share these with you before you go ahead and purchase one of these lenses. There's not too many reviews on it. So this isn't the fastest lens in the world. It has a variable aperture of f3.5 to 6.3, so maybe not the best for in museums and other low-light situations. The other issue I was having is the minimum focusing distance at 24 millimeters is a little bit further back than I'm used to at 19 inches. I'm used to being able to get a little bit closer when I'm taking pictures of flowers and things. I like to get close and blur out the background with my Sony 24 millimeter f2.8. So those are some things to consider. I filmed my intro with the DJI Pocket 3. Because the 24 millimeters turned out to be a little bit tight to vlog with, plus this thing was really heavy. So you'll pardon the fact that a lot of the clips are filmed with the DJI Pocket 3, which is becoming one of my most favorite little vlogging cameras. But I did get some test footage at 24 millimeters vlogging, and I was able to film some birds at 240 millimeters. And you'll see what happened with the focus. I had a couple issues that I wasn't really expecting. Today I am testing out the Sony 24 to 240 millimeter lens. I hate taking extra lenses when I'm traveling, but I really want the wide angle for architecture, and I want a little bit of a telephoto lens when I am, you know, at the waterfront. And I want to get close in and see the details of ships and things. So I'll let you know what I think of the lens.
They say this is bigger than Central Park.
Really? Yeah. And this is what it looks like to vlog with the 24 millimeters on the Sony a7 IV. Active steady shot is on. Some video of a bird, and I thought the optical steady shot really did do a good job, but it lost focus, which I've not usually had that happen very often. It happened quite frequently too, so I'm not sure exactly what was going on. Here's some photos I took of the waterfront and some other places around Belle Isle. I was at f6.3, 1/400th shutter speed, and ISO 100. Now, they're not nearly as sharp as what I'm used to using a prime lens, but that's to be expected. And I wasn't able to get as close as on my Sigma 100 to 400 millimeter lens, but this was a lot less bulky to carry around, and I don't think the images are horrible. Sometimes you need just one lens that can do it all. It might not be the best quality, but if it's easy to take with you, that's most important for travel. If you like this video, give it a like. Consider subscribing for more photography-related content from a newbie like me. God bless.